Rancho, cold open. I can only think of like a couple of times the government has actually helped me.
Oh no, what happened?
I'm gonna list them. I'm gonna list the times government's helped me. Number one, it's a gimme, Obamacare. Before Obamacare, I couldn't get health insurance. After it, I could. At a ludicrously more expensive price. Hundreds more dollars. Number two, remember how before we weren't allowed to move our phone numbers?
What?
You don't remember this. Okay, so if you had like a Verizon phone, you had a phone number with Verizon, but if you wanted to get AT&T, you had to get a new phone number.
Oh, fuck, I do remember that. I do remember my mom being like, you have to pick out a phone, and I'd find one. She'd be like, no, that's AT&T. We don't have AT&T.
Yes, exactly. Only in the year 2003 did they pass something called the Local Phone Number Portability Act, okay? So that's it. The only two times I could think the government has ever helped me. Can you think of any time the government's helped you?
Let me think. Let me make a valiant effort for this. I know it would be, my go-to brain is like, no, suck my cock.
Of course.
Let me seriously think about
this. Now, while you're thinking about this, I'm going to give European listeners one time Europe's government helped them. One time over in Europe, they were like, all our cell phones should have the same charger. It's just annoying that they all have different chargers. They should all have the same charge. So in Europe, they like adopted a universal cell phone standard. And over here in America, we were like, no, Apple wants to sell $80 chargers. So we didn't get that. But that's Europe government helped them one time.
I think Europe's government helps them more often than us, right?
Well, probably. That's the only thing I could think of.
But our government actively fucking hates us.
Positive thing. When is the government helping
you? Okay, okay. I got a couple.
Okay, what do you got?
Now, this is riding off of yours, but Obamacare did make it so you could stay on your parents' health insurance until you're 26.
You know what? Okay, that's another time the government's helped us.
That owned.
Okay.
That was real
good.
That was good for me in college.
That was good. Yeah, it was good for my little brothers.
So many UTIs in college.
You did?
It was good. Oh, yeah. Oh, baby.
What's up with those?
I don't know.
You get them a lot?
Yeah, it's my one argument when everybody brings up, starts arguing about like, oh, God made intelligent design because this couldn't just naturally happen. I'm like, no, women have a disease that they get from procreating. So eat that, God.
You get UTIs from sex?
You get UTIs from everything.
That's what I see. I thought you got UTIs from non-sex things too.
The reason why men do not get a urinary tract infection, listener, is an infection in your urethra. It technically can happen to men or women, but men don't usually get them because your urethras are a lot longer, so the bacteria don't get to your kidneys as fast. Women, they're just real. I guess I just got a real short urethra or something.
So Hank Hill, maybe he was always so grumpy because his urethra was super narrow, which is short the other way, if you think about it.
Oh, yeah. No, dude. And it hurts. If you've never had one, bruh, it is being in hell. Imagine, like, taking some fire ants and putting them up your pee-pee. That's what having
is that bad?
Yes.
It's like kidney stones for girls?
Kidney stones are kidney stones for girls.
You guys can get kidney stones?
Whatever. I like the fact that we got a lot more time on our parents' health insurance. Number two, I like the concept of the post office.
You know what? It is cheaper than FedEx and UPS. It is.
Right. Like, listener, if you ever need to mail anything, just look at the USPS. Is that the government one?
The United States Postal Service. Yes.
Look at that price versus what FedEx will charge you. And if FedEx and UPS got together and they just like got rid of the fucking post office, we would never have mail again. We would never be able to buy anything off the internet ever again.
No, I agree with that. You know what? Look, the other day I had one of my classic post office things where I'm standing in line. I set a timer and it was 35 minutes. I was in the package line. And I felt bad because there were old people behind me and I was like, you guys are dying right now, like right in front of my eyes. Like, this is time you could be spending with your grandkids. And they were trying to get me to freak out. They're like, haven't you knocked on the thing? Have you rang the bell? And I'm like, I rang the bell, not that thing. They're like, why aren't you more mad? I'm like, because I accept that I've given up on life.
I've run into those people so many times. One time, I shit you not, I got to the post office before it opened and there was even a line. Yeah. They're waiting for packages. I'm like, oh, fuck. But I'm like second in line and the people just don't give a shit. Yeah. Like the people that work there just do not fucking care. So we're standing there for 20 minutes. I'm on my phone because I'm a rational human being. And the guy behind me is like, can you believe this? Can you believe this? He's trying to like stir me up. He's like, I can't believe this. What the fuck? Where are they? Where are they? I'm like, bro, if you're trying to get somebody to bang on the glass, it's not gonna be me. I'm sorry. You happen to get the person that's got the patience of fucking St. Peter over here. No, you're gonna have to go bang on the glass. You're not gonna convince me to do it.
I don't even think it's that you and I have patience. I think we've just accepted our lot in life. It's just like, I'm gonna get fucked at the post office, but it's cheaper than UPS and FedEx.
Yes.
There's now one more way the government has helped us.
Tell me.
This is what I've been building to. Daylight savings time is dead as of today.
Good. Fuck daylight savings time.
Exactly. No more clocks back, clocks forward. No more clock shuffling.
Wait, they got rid of it forever?
I was wondering why your reaction wasn't bigger.
What?
Today, the federal government met. The Senate met. There's a thing called the Sunshine Protection Act. Great branding. Good luck being against the Sunshine Protection. What are you, anti-sunshine? Today, they passed it unanimous consent. Here's what unanimous consent means. They put the bill on the floor. They go, does anybody object to this? Nobody says anything. They go, all in favor say aye. Everybody says aye. Bang, boom, it's a law.
Oh my God, we don't have daylight savings time anymore?
It's gone, baby. The Daylight Protection Act got passed today. Third time the government's helped me.
Oh, I'm so happy, man. Listeners, do other countries have daylight savings time?
I don't think so. Does it sound like something other countries have?
Other countries, tell me if you've ever gotten out of work at 4:30 and it was already dark as midnight. Tell me if you've experienced that, then you do have daylight savings time.
And here's the thing. They timed it perfectly. They timed it for when we got the extra hour.
Yeah.
They didn't pass it on the day when the hour went away. So now forever, this Senate gave me an extra hour of sleep for the rest of my life.
Why the fuck did we even have that in the first place?
Someone a long time ago told me it was because it was a way to make sure that, like, kids always woke up to help with the farm chores before they went to school.
But why only half of the year, then?
Because of this crop rotations?
Whatever.
I don't care. The Sunshine Protection passed today!
Oh, fuck yeah.
Now,
thank
it still
you.
Needs to go through the Congress. Went through the Senate. Well, and Biden still needs to sign it.
Well, I want to see which members of our Congress are dick riding for daylight savings time, because I know whose office I'm going to soundly defeat the next time I'm allowed to fly again.
I love it. Good. Good. You just made it so I didn't have to edit anything.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Now look, again, this may not pass. Biden may veto it. He may fall asleep on the veto button. We don't know what's going to happen with this guy. This poor old man. This Skeletor needs a nap, for Christ's sakes.
I would bet you that this is the thing that starts Civil War too. Like, it's not Russia and Ukraine. It's not fucking anything stealing the election. It's going to be Joe Biden is going to veto daylight savings time, and we're all going to get together to just destroy the Capitol.
What if Joe Biden's like, I need it to be dark earlier so I can take long naps. Daddy, Grandpa needs night. Sky or bed for Grandpa. What if he's a vampire, which would explain how old he is and looks and sounds? I'm telling you right now, you see Joe Biden enter a room with a cape. That's not off color for Joe Biden. This guy looks weird without a cape on.
Yeah, I wish he would just die.
Hey, look, time makes fools of us all.
Time does make fools. You know where I got that from?
What? The quote, I wish he would just die? Where did you get that from?
No, I was playing a video game when I was like 12, and it would censor the word kill. So I had to say, I'm going to soundly defeat this person, and then it just stuck. 12 years.
Oh, I thought that was some sort of I thought that was like with the Minecraft kit. Okay, I didn't know.
Yeah, whatever.
I like your thing.
It was in Minecraft before there was Minecraft.
There you go. I'm turning 40 this year. I can now point to three things the government has done that I've liked. If they did that cell phone thing, whoever's in charge when they do the cell phone thing eventually, boom, I'll vote for your party for life. Republicans, Democrats, I don't care. I'm a single issue voter. And that issue is, why don't all cell phones have the same charging thing? Why?
Fuck, they should. They should. And then Apple fucks with it every couple of years.
Yes!
To fuck you and make you buy whole new chargers and headphones. You're like, you know what? No more headphone port. Fuck you. Buy your headphones.
It's insane that one company has this kind of power. One company has the power to invalidate your treadmills. How many times have you gone on a treadmill and they have the old iPhone charger?
I've never been on a treadmill that had the proper iPhone charging cable.
I've never been. You know why? I'll tell you why. Because when the lightning charger thing came out, the treadmill companies were like, we fold. That's it. You're just getting TV now. And like some of these treadmill companies are like, you can connect it through Bluetooth. I'm not connecting it through Bluetooth. I'm not. I've given up. I'll just watch CNN. You know what? The only time I watch Law and Order? On the treadmill. I think that's, it's only played on treadmills now.
It is. That's, they have an exclusive contract with what are those, Life Fit or the ones the ones that are all over the place. I am so happy that you brought up politics because I'm going to say the most controversial thing I've ever said on this podcast.
Controversial?
Controversial. I'm talking to the LGBTQ community. Listen to me. This is my most hot take. If you have on your wall a flag, please steam it one time.
Steam your flags?
As decorations. I'm sick of walking into people's houses and seeing it like folded, like creased straight out of the bag. If you don't live in a dorm room, you can find an iron. Just iron it one time, please.
You're seeing unsteamed flags?
Yes.
Where are you running into unsteamed flags? I like my flag steamy. I want the steamiest flags you can get.
No.
I'm looking for the silk stockings of flags. The USA's up all night of flags.
Because I'm going to visit my friend soon, and they have a bunch of those gay flags in their house, and they're all like, they just came out of the bag. Like, they have this square pattern on them. Just steam it once.
Did they just come out of the closet?
No.
Your friends?
No. Nobody is gay.
Your friends are old gays with new flags.
Yes.
They gotta get some old flags. Here's what you gotta do. You gotta go down to the gay store, which is where they sell rainbow magnets and such. They should have used like 1980s vintage gay pride flags. You know, kind of like how when we were kids that you could buy like a distressed pair of jeans.
Yes.
You need to be able to buy a distressed pride flag to be like, I've always been down for the cause.
Yeah, I'm going to start a business. I feel like this isn't hitting with you, but let me tell you.
Wait,
everyone,
No. Can you, if you don't mind telling me, just because I'm doing my Jerry Savile impression, this has happened recently because of Ukraine. Because like a lot of people, they're like, I love Ukraine. I love Ukraine. It's very clear they just bought these flags because the Ukrainian flags they're waving around have the big creases in the middle. And so I have recently noticed this too.
I'm giving the Ukrainian flags a pass because that just happened. So people are probably still getting them in from their AliExpress orders. But you fuckers have had, I know you've had that Buy Pride flag in your living room for 3 years. It's time to steam it.
You're
take it
to
down.
Friends?
I'm talking to that I'm talking to you, listener. You. Take it down.
Are you specific? Okay, now granted, we're always talking to the listener. Hi, listener.
Hi, listener.
Your friends listen to this podcast. Are you also just talking to your friends?
No, I'm talking to the person listening to this podcast right now.
Okay.
You. And also, iced coffee's not a meal. Go eat something. Fuck you.
Sometimes when people eat meals, you call them fat.
Yeah, that's when I eat meals.
So you're allowed to have iced coffee as a meal?
Yes, because I am fat.
You're not fat.
All right, whatever. I won't get into this.
All right. I just hate it when you do that. You're insulting my fiance. I don't like it. All right. Steam your flags. I don't care if you just bought a Ukrainian flag or you've got a three-year-old bi pride. What are the bi pride colors?
Blue, pink, and purple.
Isn't that very close to the trans pride colors? Which is blue and pink?
Trans are, no, it's different shades.
Different shades?
Yeah, the bi flag is like dark. It magenta, I would call it.
Okay.
A dark purple, maybe a royal, and a navy. It's darker.
Can I tell you what proportions I'd put on the bi pride flag?
What?
Look, and again, no offense, which is, by the way, what every person who's about to turn 40 should say before they say anything.
Yeah, just hi, start all your emails. Hi, my name is Asterios. No offense. We have a meeting.
You know what also?
I don't think no offense has ever worked. No offense. Your breast smells terrible. I'm offended. In fact, you saying no offense put me on alert to be offended. I was a little offended before you said anything. I've started the offended process.
Yeah, no. Here's what you got to do. Here's a little sriracha hack for you. Yeah. Don't say no offense anymore. It's played out. It's done. It's 90s. Nobody likes it.
Okay.
What you say is you start your sentence with the phrase, I am saying this in the nicest way possible, or I mean this in the nicest possible way. You need to go brush your teeth or something like that. Really, I think that hits different with people.
No, that does hit different. Oh, I like that. Okay, look, I mean this in the nicest way possible. 80% purple. We associate bisexuality with purple. We just do. We named a whole kind of lighting after it, and it's the purple lighting.
Who's we, Kimosabe? Isn't the bi lighting pink and dark blue because of the flag?
I think it's purple.
I don't know. Look that up.
Okay.
Waller, look that up.
All right, hold on. Click, 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 click. No, it's just here. Stairs is right.
Oh, okay.
Well, wait, do you want to look it up? Look it up.
Okay, I'll look it up. I have a computer in my brain. Click, 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 click. It says, I mean, this in the nicest way possible. Stairs is stupid. And Sriracha is always right.
Oh, hold on. Let me check your results. Okay, click, 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 click. Oh, it says your computer has been set to idiot mode, which must be why you're using it.
Click, 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 click. Well, my computer says that your computer is not going to work until you lick my asshole because it's got a very rare malware.
Click, 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 click. My computer says it's sorry that you're so stupid.
My computer says fight 1v1 me, bitch.
Okay, let's let our computers fight. All right, they're fighting. All right, I'm at the bisexual flag Wikipedia page.
Was I right about the colors?
You were 1,000,000% right. This is a very different blue. This almost has two purples on it. This makes sense to me.
I saw a TikTok the other day of someone commenting, what is that pride flag on your wall? I don't recognize it. And then the person stitches it and slowly leans back so you can see it. And it's an Ireland flag. Ireland.
Licensing controversy. In 1988, the bisexual pride flag, the creator of it, whose name was Michael Page, said it was free for public and commercial use. It was not patented, trademarked, or service mark. But in April 2020, a website called Binet USA falsely claimed that it was the sole copyright owner of the flag and said that organizations who wish to use the flag would be required to obtain a license from the organization despite having nothing to do with the flag's creation. God, that's the straightest thing the Binet could do. I expect that out of straights.
I was going to say, did Nathan Masry run this website?
Straight net? That's a very straight net move, Binet. Binet's claim the resulting controversy were covered by both out and LGBTQ nation. The double barrels of the LGBTQ media were aimed squarely at Binet, which cast doubt on Binet's claim and noted that the flag was not eligible for copyright. On April 29th, 2020, Binet USA made a tweet claiming that the Wikipedia page for the bisexual pride flag that criticizes Binet was inaccurate. Binet USA ultimately ceased to use the flag on May 8th, opting instead to use a different design.
Well, listeners, we hope you enjoyed this deep dive into the Wikipedia page about Binet and the bi flag. Welcome back to Fun with Flags with Sheldon and Amy. This time it's gay flags.
Here we go. Bisexual lighting is the simultaneous use of pink, purple, and blue lighting to represent bisexual characters. So we were both right. I said it was purple. You said it was pink and blue.
I was righter.
It's more. Purple's right in the middle. You know what happens when you mix pink and blue? You got purple.
I know, but I got 2/3 of it right, and you only got 1/3 of it right, so I win.
But I got the key shade.
No, you didn't.
The purple is the key shade. It's right in the middle of the bisexual flag. It represents the intersection between the traditionally gendered colors.
Cool. I don't care. I got it right. Everybody who's bi, vote in the comments below who got it right.
Okay. Everybody who's bi, what do you associate more with bisexuality? Pink and blue, which are the colors of traditionally gendered boys and girls. You know, in the 1980s, we had a whole thing about pink and blue. or purple, the cool shade.
Yeah,
everybody's nice. Mix them up. Look, when you go to McDonald's and you get yourself a flurry, do you want them to just pour M&M's on top, or do you want them to mix them up?
Know what the fuck you're talking about.
Or do you want them to mix them up? Where do you want your mini M&Ms?
I want them in my mouth.
You want them to mix them up. You want them in the middle. Just like purple, right in the middle. Most important color.
Now we're going to have to put this to a vote.
Look, a Big Mac. What makes a Big Mac different than a double cheeseburger?
It has a bun.
In the middle. Yes. Just like the bisexual flag has purple in the middle.
It also has different patties.
It does?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Big Mac has two different patties?
It has different patties from the double cheeseburger.
Okay.
And it also has the Mac sauce, which you don't get on the double cheeseburger.
What is the Mac sauce?
I've heard that it's like French dressing and cream or something. I don't remember. I have no idea. I think it's French dressing and mayonnaise, but it comes in bags, so I don't know.
Okay. I'm right.
I'm right.
You know I'm right.
I'm right. I'm right about the composition of a Big Mac, and I'm right about the composition of this lighting debate debacle, too.
I'm just saying, this flag might as well have two purples. This pink is so far into purple, they might as well call this flag purple and purpler with some blue.
Sure.
Which means I'm right.
Yeah, okay.
Now, look, I will admit to being wrong about something. I clogged the toilet.
Oh, I know you did.
And I'm sorry. I admit it. And I'm not just saying this because I was soundly defeated in the poll. When we asked people who clogged the toilet, 65-45, everyone thought I clogged the toilet.
Because you did. And I will say, it is not okay, but you are forgiven.
Can I tell you how I determined that I clogged the toilet?
Sure.
Okay. I entered the bathroom and I saw a crystal clear, serene toilet. Nary a scrap of toilet paper to be found. You could see all the way to the bottom of the toilet. It was like the Aegean Sea in Greece, which we should maybe go to on our honeymoon.
Okay.
And, you know, and I did what I do when I go to the bathroom.
As Jocelyn would say, doing her number ones and her number twos.
Yeah, on the ones and twos. And then I get up, I go to flush, and thanks to my organic diet, and I'm not gonna get too far into it because that was a particularly gross episode.
Yeah.
No one could eat lunch again, which you think is good.
Yeah, uh-huh. Especially if it's me.
What I'm producing are masterpieces.
Okay, cool.
I'm just telling you. Some people, a doctor would look in the toilet and they'd go, "You got problems. This is all over the place," they'd say. They'd go, "The spectrum of density here is wild." They'd be like, "There's no consistency to this. Over here, it's as dense as a neutron star. Over here, it might as well be the inside of a helium atom."
Well, that's a very specific reference that I'm sure somebody gets.
But to me, consistency. It's all part of one.
Okay, cool. Enough about your shit. Can you please move on to how you know this clogged the toilet?
It's all part of one beautiful system when I make. And speaking of systems, I don't think the septic system appreciates what I'm doing because it's going, "I'm not used to this. I'm used to the American style diet. And what you've made is too beautiful for even an American style toilet to accept. If I were over in Europe, they'd be fine with it. Not here in America." Once again, I'm ahead of my time.
You need to start going to the bathroom at the gym because then you get access to the industrial toilets.
I need that knife they talk about.
The poop knife?
I don't know what they call it. I know there is a knife. I think I need the knife.
It's the award that you could give on Reddit, the poop knife award. Because I think somebody posted that. They were like, "Does anybody else, where do you put your poop knife after you take a shit?" They're like, "What the fuck is a poop knife?"
I think I need the knife. I think I need the knife because of what I'm up to. I'm doing too good a job. As usual, I'm too good.
Yeah.
At what I do. You know how I've had like a rock solid comedy career?
Yes.
Just all hits, all bangers, start to finish.
Every podcast is good and still going.
Yeah, all of them. So look, is it any surprise that that's also what's happening on the ones and twos?
I guess not.
All right. Well, Do you forgive me for blaming the clogging on you when it was I don't forgive you for that.
No, I don't forgive you for that, but I do forgive you for the act itself.
No, I appreciate your forgiveness. Thank you. And I forgive you for being wrong about the color purple. Well, it's super bi.
We're going to see if the bi people agree with you. Like I said, this is not your fucking fight to fight, buddy.
It's a thing. It's a thing in their community.
Yeah. We'll be right back. Gladys Podcast.
Wait, no, seriously. It's a thing.
Yeah, I can't talk about this anymore. I can't talk about three colors for half of an hour.
You can't talk about three colors.
Yeah, no, you're going to need to take it from here, Chance.
All right, fine. Fine.
You're just going to read the fucking Wikipedia.
Yes, I will.
Going to play my Palace Harem game.
Fine.
Oh, serious. This is going to be a bad week for me. You know why? Because I've been seeing my unlucky numbers like everywhere.
You have unlucky numbers?
Yeah, don't you?
No.
Oh, okay.
That's for old, and I'm allowed to say this, Chinese grandmas.
Old Chinese grandmas.
Because my old Chinese grandma has lucky numbers.
I thought everybody had lucky and unlucky numbers.
No.
That were significant. Okay, listeners, let's have a little tale here. Let me tell you some fun facts about Sierra. So I am fucked up in the head about two things. I'm fucked up in the head about numbers, and I'm fucked up in the head about money. Like, I am real fucking weird with money. I have to, like, check my bank account multiple times a day. I check all my investments, like, if not every day, every couple of hours. And I know where that stems from. That stems from when I was a kid, my parents used to steal my money. So I would have to count it every day and hide it in multiple places. So that just evolved into an adult habit. I don't know where this numbers things come from. It might just be the awkwardness. Okay, so let me tell you about my lucky and unlucky numbers. Lucky numbers are 17 and 6. Why are they 17 and 6? 17 is because when I was in elementary school, I won a prize or something with a raffle ticket that had the number 17 on it. I literally don't remember what even the prize was. I just remember the fact that I won and it coursed through my veins like that. I've been chasing that high ever since.
So you must love 17 magazine.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
You do not?
I don't know what that is. Oh, wait, no, that's the Teen Girl. Yeah, I love that magazine.
Oh, yeah, it's called 17 Magazine. It should be your luckiest magazine. Every time you fly, you should have to buy that magazine.
Is that still in print?
17?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I'm trying to think of other uses of 17. Well, that's the only one I can think of.
Anyway, okay, and the other lucky number is 6. So 6 is important. I don't know where that came from, but it is my lucky number. 6 is important because my unlucky number is 66, which is 6 two times. So 6 go together and cancel each other out. The good luck, it's bad luck then. 666 is also an unlucky number because that's the devil thing. Now, I know what you're thinking, Sriracha. By your logic, if the numbers luck cancel each other out, then 6 would be lucky, 66 would be unlucky, 666 would be lucky. And my answer to that is go fuck yourself. And 6666 is lucky.
I think I know why.
Why?
All right, let's say two things cancel each other out and a third thing comes along. Well, those first two things have already canceled each other. Like, this third thing isn't going to just bring it up back from the dead. Like, if a TV show goes on the air and then it gets canceled and a new TV show happens, the first TV show doesn't get uncanceled.
Right.
When somebody gets killed, it's their life has been canceled. When a baby gets born, that new person doesn't come to life again. It's just like the deed is done. It's canceled.
Right. So, like, the sixes come together and they have, like, a chemical reaction.
Right.
That neutralizes the good luck and gives you bad luck.
Makes it inert.
Right. But if you add another 6, then it's like adding a single ion to a mixture. Like, you're not going to get anything. But when you add that second component, then it activates and they start interacting with the other 66s in the 6666 to create luck again.
That's what I think too, because now you have two pairs of inert guys and then you mix them together and now we're twinning, which is what happens when twins win.
Yeah, no, I seriously, and I'm fucking weird about it too, dude. If I see a 66, like, when I'm out, I will feel a little uncomfortable.
I'm going to ask you another question, and obviously, because our listeners are thinking this.
Yeah.
What about 66,666?
I don't like that one's vibe, but I wouldn't say that it's unlucky.
I'm going to show you the number, and I want to get your first reaction.
Okay.
Take a look at this.
I'm ready. If this is just a big 66, I'm going to throw that at you.
All right, 1, 2, 3.
6666, I'll kill you. This one's a little aggressive.
And it also has devil horns and a devil's tail.
Yeah, this one's a little aggressive. Not fit digging this one's vibe.
Wait, do you see a devil horns and devil's tail on this? And do you see the phrase, I'll kill you?
It's in the room with us.
I just see six numbers. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, first of all, there's five numbers.
Okay. Hold on. I'm going to write something else on this.
Okay. Turning it over now. 6666 gaslighting.
Wait, you think you're being gaslit right now?
You buy this number.
Because I'm not gaslighting you.
You're not?
No. You think you see the word gaslighting?
I think I might on this paper.
There's no word gaslighting on that paper.
You didn't write this?
Did I write the word gaslighting in the middle of the piece of paper?
I might be crazy. I must be crazy. And that is what gaslighting is, kids.
There you go, kids. That was an important lesson for you. All right. 666,666. That's 2 666, which maybe cancel each other out?
No, you're getting way too far into the weeds. Look, past 10,000, you can't have a lucky number.
You can't?
No, everything past that is totally neutral.
What about a million?
Because there's never... No, not a million. No, too high.
A million's too high to be lucky?
Yeah. After, some people, I think, would argue that you can't go past 999, even as your lucky number, because you're never going to run into a situation where you're going to need, like... A six-digit combination.
Yeah, you will. If you're playing the lotto. They have a lot of numbers in that thing.
Well, fuck the lottery. I'm just going to do all six at once.
But the lottery is entirely lucky numbers. In fact, sometimes lottery numbers have a special lucky number at the end.
Okay, well, I'll buy the lottery number 17-6, 17-6, and then my lucky number, 6.
Okay.
But wait, the 6 can't be touching because then they cancel it. Fuck.
That's what I'm saying.
I need to think about this. It's like a very, very awkward version of Sudoku.
What about the number 8? What do you think?
It doesn't offend me, but I don't love it.
Isn't it weird how it's kind of just an infinity symbol?
You know why I hate the number 8? I don't hate the number 8. You know why I dislike the number 8? Is because 8 times 7 is totally fucked. Like,
what is 8 times 7? 42?
I can't. I don't know. Exactly.
Oh,
nobody knows.
No, what's 8 times 7?
8 times 8, 64. 8 times 6.
No, 6 times 8 is 48.
Yes.
Right. You said 64.
No, I said 8 times 8.
Which is 64. I'm sorry. You're right. 8 times 8 is 64.
8 times 4
is 32.
24? Wait.
8. 8, 16, 24, 32. 32.
Yeah. 8 times 7? Don't know. There's just a hole missing.
Oh, my God. 8 times 5 is 45, right? No, 9 times 5. 9 times 5 is 45.
8 times 5 is 40 because it's an even number.
It's an even number on the fives. Got it, on the eights and fives. Okay, what do you think of the number 0?
Don't like it.
Why?
Don't like it. Don't like it because it symbolizes, I don't like the fact that it can't be, you can't divide by it. That makes it a shady motherfucker. Like, you could divide by a negative number, but you can't divide by you. Fuck you. I don't like it. I don't like that it doesn't have a negative counterpart because that kind of makes it the nexus of numbers, the liminal space of numbers. Don't like it. Don't like its vibe. Creeps me out.
Let me tell you why I kind of like the number 8. Snowman. Isn't that fun?
I thought we were talking about the number 0.
I moved back because I don't like 0 either. We agree on 0. Okay. 8, a little snowman. I like that.
Nope, don't like it. Hate it.
What do you think of the number 10?
Ooh, the number 10 is good.
It's like a little party. Yeah. There's a 1 there, there's a 0 there. They're having a little party, you know?
Yeah, I like the number 10. I do like the number 10. It doesn't reach lucky number status, but I like the way it looks.
What do you think of the number 100? I like the number 100.
Don't like that one.
Wait, why?
I don't know. Too many zeros.
I hear you. It does have a lot of zeros.
Yeah.
Just 100 to me sounds big. It's like $100. I've been doing this for 100 days. I've been running for 100 minutes. I like that. Look, $100 bill. That's a pretty cool bill. I think they make $1,000 bill. I don't know. I've never seen it. I may never see it.
See, I like the number 1,000. But the only reason that I like the number 1,000 is because when I'm organizing my money, I'll sort things into groups of $1,000.
You have $1,000 that you can sort? Wait, you have multiple groups of 1,000?
Oh, am I?
Why aren't we married yet? We need to combine these finances.
Oh, buddy, no, we can't. I will have a fucking conniption.
You know what? Can we switch to that topic real quick? quick?
Yeah,
is that
let's
okay?
do it. Yeah, go for
okay.
it.
Okay. Listeners, as I've brought up many times before, I now have a real, for the first time since the Troubles, I have a real job that gives me a real shot to one day buy a house. Before this, bye-bye house. Never buying a house. Full-time renter Okanos is what, but now it's just like, look, if I don't go out to eat too much and if I don't act like an asshole, I could maybe buy a house. So Rancho and I, we've been talking for a while about like getting a joint account so we can both put some money away to buy a house. Now, we were supposed to do this like 6 months ago. We had the agreement to do this 6 months ago, and Sarancha gave like a ridiculous, I'm not going to say that, she gave a ludicrous number as to how much money she could put towards a house each month. And I was like, yeah, I could do that too. Yeah, I'll do it. Let's just start the account. And then every time I would try to get together with her and open up like a joint account, she'd get a little bit antsy.
Yeah, because just thinking about all the things that could go wrong.
Only yesterday did I realize that's what it was.
Mm-hmm.
Before then, I just thought you were procrastinating.
I never procrastinate.
But then yesterday, I like sit her down. And I'm like, can we finally open up this joint account? And she's like, can we do it next week? And I'm like, do you just not want to do it? And she's like, I just don't want to do it. I'm like, oh, now I get it. Yeah. Okay. So I opened up my own little account so I could put little money towards a house. And this is one of the things that boomers like. When you open up like a new financial account, they'll throw bonuses at you. Bonuses, bonuses, bonuses. Like you open up a new credit card, they'll be like, for every dollar the first year, we'll give you a dollar. Because they're trying to get you to like fall massively into credit card debt. So you can get like a bonus $10. We fall for it every time, us fucking boomers.
But the vesting benefits, that's the opposite of going into debt, right? Unless you bought fucking meme stocks, it sucks to suck. That's probably not coming back.
With the investing thing today, there was a thing where they're like, well, if you put $10,000 in this account, we'll give you $50. And I was like, $10,000? You know I don't have that. I was like, why are you even offering me the sweet, sweet $50 prize in the first place? Most of these investing accounts, they like have a minimum balance. They want $10,000 before they'll start giving you any amount of money.
What in the fuck?
Fidelity, E-Trade, a lot of like the big brokerage ones, they have a very high minimum for the bonus. Obviously, you could start a brokerage account for zero.
For the bonus. I was going to say, I thought they got rid of that.
No, it's, but I want the bonus, except for SoFi. SoFi has a thing where they're like, if you open up a brokerage account with us, you can play the claw game.
See, this is why we can't combine our finances, because this is how you think.
You can play the claw game.
This is how you make decisions.
And I'm like, what's the claw game? And they're like, you download our app, you push a button, and a virtual claw goes over a bunch of stocks, and it could grab like $1,000 share of Apple and then put it in your account. Boom, the claw game. The claw game.
They had that for Robinhood for a while. I got fucking Fitbit. There wasn't a claw game, but you got a free stock when you opened an account a bunch of years ago. I got fucking Fitbit, and then it went under.
You know what? Robinhood still has that thing where they're like, we'll give you a free stock. I'm like, that could be anything. SoFi, the claw game.
Okay, let's play.
All right. I'm going to play the claw game. And by the way, if I get the right stock, we might move into a house tomorrow if you think about
it. Yeah, you could get a stock of Berkshire Hathaway A? That's like 10,000.
There you go, A-class Berkshire Hathaway. Okay, now listen. While I'm downloading this SoFi app, I have a couple of questions for you.
I'm ready.
Because without getting too far into it, you know a lot about mortgages.
I do.
You know a lot about buying houses.
And right. Money in general.
All right, question number one. What's a mortgage?
It's a loan for a house.
Can I get a mortgage for fun?
Yes.
Can I get a mortgage and then go to Disneyland with that mortgage?
No, you cannot. There are like, I know you're asking this as a meme, but no.
I'm not asking this as a meme. Does a mortgage have to be tied to a house? Can I get a mortgage and then buy a cool car?
No, because that's just a loan.
Okay, I don't know. This is why I'm asking. So a mortgage has to be for the house.
Yeah, you have to send somebody. Here's how have to be at the house it is. Before you close it alone, you have to send somebody to your house to verify, yes, this is a house that people can live in. Before a bank will sign off on your loan, it's called an appraisal.
I got to invite the banker to my house.
Not the banker, but they send an appraiser to your house who doesn't, not an inspector, because the inspector goes around like testing out what's in
there. There's a difference between an appraiser and an inspector. Do I need them both?
Yes.
Okay, I was afraid you'd say that. If it were me, I would open up a service called Asterios Kokonos is an appraiser and inspector. The two for one deal.
Yeah, well, get your you got a license for that appraisal.
I don't have a license for either of these things. What does the appraiser do?
I shit you not. This is what an appraiser does.
Appraiser.
You have to hire an inspector. The bank won't require you to hire an inspector, but most people do. But they will require you to get an appraiser, which is just a guy that goes to your house, doesn't test anything, doesn't look at your system, just like kind of sniffs around a little bit and says, yeah, this is a house that people could live in. There's not an infestation of bats in here. And then gives like a rough estimate of what the house is worth and sends it to the bank. And the bank looks at it and is like, oh, okay, good. We're loaning you money. We're loaning you $250,000 for a home that's worth $275,000 and not a cave full of bats worth $1,500.
Okay. Have you heard about the racism lawsuits?
No.
Okay. So this one African-American family, they own a home and they've done a lot of work to it. And they're like, this home is now worth $750,000. They get an appraiser to come in. The appraiser's like, it's only worth $500,000. They're like, what the fuck? So then they take down all their pictures. They get their white friend to come to the house. They hang up the white people's pictures.
They put up 13 jars of mayonnaise in the fridge.
Exactly.
They played Sweet Caroline for 3 days straight.
Yes. And then a different appraiser came by, and that appraiser was like, this is worth $750,000. And they're like, okay, we're suing that first appraiser for being racist. And that first appraiser's like, yeah, what are you going to do?
Yeah, you got me.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, could we make racism work for us? Could we go to a house that we like, and then maybe.
What? Da-da, yeah, no, what are you going to say, Asterios? Come on, you started the sentence.
Could we make it? Could we take advantage of the appraiser's inherent racial biases?
I don't think so, because the owner of the house, like, I don't think you can fuck with, unless you are the owner of the house, I don't think you can fuck with the owner of the house, because the owner of the house is just going to be there.
What if we get the owner? Okay, here's how we do it. We get the owner of the house caught up in a traffic jam that we start. We get a bunch of friends of ours to do like one of those improv everywhere style happenings, a flash mob on the freeway. And then while that's happening, we make the house. We paint the house to take advantage of the appraiser's natural biases.
I like how you're thinking, fill it with bats.
What? Wait a minute. That's a much better idea. Okay, hold on.
So cute.
Hold on. Sarantia.
Yes.
Could we do something similar, but in reverse? Have you heard of something called reverse racism?
Yes.
Okay. What if we reverse the polarity on the racism? So we see a house we like, okay? Now, the house is owned by somebody. We're trying to buy the house from them. They're going to say this is a $1 million house. We set the owner up so that they're, like, caught in a big traffic jam on the freeway. Like, we do something, like, out of the Michael Keaton Batman movie where, like, somebody just starts throwing dollar bills on the freeway. Everyone's running on the freeway trying to grab these dollar bills. So we spend, like, $1,000 in dollar bills. And whoever's throwing the dollar bills out is, like, one of our buddies, and they're just like, death to capitalism. Everything should be free, man. Now the owner is caught in a traffic jam. And then when the appraiser comes to the house, fill the house with bats.
Love it.
There's bats all over the house. It's Guano City, baby. It's when people are like, does Batman live here? Speaking of Michael Keaton, it all comes around in a big circle. We go the full Batman.
I love it. And I want a connection. I could probably build a connection I'll do this multiple times. I'll become a real estate investor or a bat investor. And then I will make a connection with a bat farmer somewhere in Moldova. I'll have entire crates of bats shipped to me without proper licensure. And they'll be like, oh, where are all these bats come from? And I'll be like, I don't know. Don't ask them if they speak Romanian. I don't know.
And then we flip the house, okay? So then here's what we do. A couple of days later, now we're trying to sell the house. And we do the thing again where we set up like a traffic jam. We say, there's a traffic jam. Then when the appraiser comes to the house, it's filled with beautiful birds, beautifully colored macaws and cockatoos and cockatiels. And who? And the appraiser walks in and they're like, this person must have a lot of money because they have a lot of beautiful birds. This house is worth double, double bird house.
And I'm the appraiser and I have a fake mustache on.
Why? I mean, honestly, we should just do that. Why don't you just become the appraiser and appraise the house at a price that would be advantageous to me? What if we committed securities fraud?
Is that what that is? I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know what a security is. I don't have it. Now that I have this job, I finally have a little bit of it and I can play the claw game. Okay, so you have to get a house with a mortgage. Now, you've told me a long time ago that you have to have like anti-fraud. You have to have an insurance on your mortgage?
If you, listener, have less than 20% to put down on your house when you buy it and you're using a conventional loan.
Okay.
I shit you not. You have to buy. This is how fucked the entire mortgage process is. You have to buy a special type of insurance called, I think, loan insurance.
Okay.
I don't remember the exact name. I should remember it. I have a feeling it starts with an F, but I don't remember. You have to buy insurance for your loan that is hundreds of dollars a month and provides you with absolutely no benefits. But if you default on your loan, the insurance provider will pay the bank back and you have to pay for that.
Well, wait a minute. Then why am I paying a mortgage and for loan insurance? Why don't I just pay for loan insurance, not the mortgage? Now the loan insurance is paying the mortgage and we've cut out the middleman.
Yeah, why do you need that? Oh, fuck you. We hate poor people. That's why.
Okay. Real talk. This is a real question. How much money do I have to have down? I genuinely don't know. I always thought it was 10%. You've started throwing the number 20 around recently. What's my down payment? What do I need?
I mean, I wouldn't go any less than 20 unless you're buying it with like a weird loan, like a USDA loan or something.
A USDA, like the stakes?
Yeah.
Like a USDA, like a choice, like a ground chuck loan. What are the kinds of loans? I thought they were just mortgages.
Okay, we got conventional loans. That's most loans. They'll get sold to Fannie and Freddie, probably.
I keep hearing about these two people. Tell me anything about Fannie and Freddie.
No idea what they are. Just know they buy mortgages. They buy it from the bank and then they take on the securities.
So I get a loan from the bank, and I buy insurance to make sure the bank gets paid, but then the bank makes sure they get paid from Fannie and Freddie?
Yes, correct.
Who pays Fannie and Freddie?
The bank takes your loan. It goes to Freddie Mae or Fannie Mae. I don't remember what they're called.
Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae.
Yeah.
I know that much.
It's like, I will sell you this loan. Here's the chances of them defaulting.
So Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae buy the mortgage from the bank, and then I took out the loan. The bank gave me the money. Then Fannie and Freddie gives the bank money?
Yeah, I think so.
Who gives Fannie and Freddie the money?
Probably the government.
Why can't I just take a loan out straight from the government?
Because you're not a bank.
Are you fucking serious with this shit? Why can't I just knock on Joey Biden's door, Joseph Robinette Biden, and go bang, 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 bang. I got a new job now. I'm playing the claw machine. Give me some money for a house.
Joseph Robinette Biden, give me some money. Yeah, no, it's great. The whole system's fucked.
You don't have an answer.
I don't. Why can't you go to the government and get a loan? Seriously, I don't know.
This is your fault.
This is my fault.
Okay. I'm going to put, before I play the claw game, this is maybe the only time our listeners may ever learn this stuff. Can you give me any more information about how to get a house? I didn't really know what a mortgage was until this conversation. Give me any more information.
Okay, bang. Here's a good option if you live in the middle of bumfuck nowhere. There's these things called USDA loans.
Okay.
Which are loans that the Department of Agriculture backs, which means that if you default them, then the government will pay the bank back. And for that reason, you could buy a home. You can buy a home with no down payment. You do have to still pay closing costs. But there are rules to this. You have to live in the house. You have to be in a shithole area. Like, there's a calculator. There's a calculator. No, not a calculator. Like a map. You could go on the USDA website and search for your zip code. If they determine that is bumfuck enough for a USDA loan, you'll be approved. You also have to do income requirements and shit. If you're a veteran or you're married to one, you could get a VA loan, which is also $0 down. An FHA loan, you don't need to pay mortgage insurance on, but you do have to pay a 1% mortgage insurance to the government. But that's like less than a bank would charge you. But only if you don't have 20% down. And if you reach 20% down, then you could just refinance it into a normal loan. And then fuck you, no more money towards the government. But if you just keep it as an FHA loan, you have to pay that for fucking ever. That's bullshit.
So what's the best loan? Which one should I go for? USDA, FHA, veterans, traditional? What's the good one?
I mean, if I didn't live in New York City, I'd get a USDA loan.
Okay, so I can buy. So there's a map right now I can look at of the shitty parts of America.
Fuck yeah. Go Google right now.
Okay.
USDA loan zip codes. And it's a map. You can enter your zip code and the government will tell you if you live in bumfuck or not.
Okay. I'm at the USDA Rural Development U.S. Department of Agriculture website at rd.usda.gov. All right.
Pick a zip code.
New York. I'm looking for assistance for meat processors. No! My USDA mortgage information. Yeah, eligibility information?
Yeah,
okay, eligibility information.
Our teenage audience is going to love this.
Single family housing guaranteed. Do I want a guaranteed or direct loan?
Guaranteed.
All right, guaranteed loan. Oh, we can live in New York. We can live in Poughkeepsie.
Where the fuck is that?
It's Wappingers Falls. So around Myers Corner? Ditto? You know, the Fishkill Plains? By Hopewell Junction, Poughkeepsie. We can live in East Fishkill? Now that's how you know it's a good place. When it's named after what you kill there.
Yeah, you need the word kill in there. That's actually one of the rules. You can go to Mount Kilkenny. You go to Fishkill.
Wait a minute. A lot of Long Island. Oh, no, wait. Oh, no, wait. This is the... I'm looking at the wrong color. No, we could never afford Fishkill. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
Fishkill is completely ineligible. You and I, we can only dream of getting one of these loans in Fishkill.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you go out to like Nebraska, the entire state's great.
All right. How would you like to live in Twerksbury?
Where's that?
In New Jersey, right by Clinton Township, Bedminster. Peapack Gladstone, we could live in Twerksbury.
That sounds like a place with an abandoned mall in it. So yeah, sure, I'll move there.
We could go swimming in Bud Lake.
Ew.
I'm not living in Twerksbury. All right, these loans. Okay, I'm never, just say it. I can never buy a house. I'm never going to be able to afford
never,
a house. I'm never going to get a house. The American dream is dead for me.
It is.
They're going to find me entombed in cat hair. Just admit it.
And bird feathers.
And bird feathers, which is pretty cute. All right, I'm going to play the claw game.
Yes, fuck yeah, I can't wait.
I've opened my account.
Ooh.
I added $50 to it. I might need to borrow money from you after this. And now I get to drop the claw to play the game. It's time to play the claw game.
Ooh, I'm so excited.
All right, I'm pushing the claw now. 3, 2, 1, claw game. Come on, give me a house.
Yeah. Oh,
come on. You see the claw?
You have to press drop. Oh, it's going in.
There goes the claw. Tell me what's happening.
It's going in the pile of presents. It's pulled out a yellow box. And inside that box, $5 worth of stock.
$5?
I knew it.
Thank you for playing. You won $5 worth of stock. It said I could win up to $1,000.
Yeah, that means you get $1,000. So I don't know what this scam was.
This isn't...
never get a house with this $5 stock. I love that they put the number 5 in candles on a piece of cake. I don't know why this claw grabbed a present and then there was cake inside. This is probably some old, disgusting cake.
What did they give you specific stock, or did you just have a $5 credit on your account now?
It says choose your stock. I'll let you choose it.
Oh, that's like you could get a 1/100th of a VIX, whatever.
Can you please pick a stock that I could trade for a house?
Okay. Yeah, all right. How about GameStop?
Are you serious? I lost $800 on GameStop last year.
Oh, okay. I'm looking for ones that I have.
I told my accountant that I lost $800 in GameStop. Was there anything he could do to make that better for my taxes? And he was like, he just wrote back like those laughing emojis. And then I was like, oh, okay. Ooh, he thought I was joking.
Carnival Cruise Line. Yeah. They're gonna do real well.
Carnival Cruise Line? Well, the pandemic is over.
Yeah, the pandemic's over. We're bored of it, and ergo, it is over. Okay.
All right! Woo! I'm a Carnival Cruise Line shareholder, baby! Everyone listen to this! Book a Carnival Cruise today! If enough of you book Carnival Cruises, I'll get a new house! If they could see me now, I'll hop on a sunshine cruise! Da 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 da. If my friends can't see me now, we'll be right back after. Would you not know what I'm doing?
No, but I like it. I'm into it.
Okay, because there's the famous commercial. We'll be right back after this with more of the Loudest Podcast.
That's it for the Loudest Podcast. This is our most random episode ever.
Yeah, like, you hope you 15-year-olds enjoy all that finance and mortgage talk.
You thought the same thing about the job interview, guys. And the next thing you know, we got people getting new jobs. And the next thing you know, we're getting more Patreon bucks.
Yeah, you know what? Fuck you. I take that back, because the public school system doesn't teach you jack shit about finance.
Of course it doesn't. I'm turning 40. I don't know what a mortgage is.
Well, kids, you're welcome. You just got more education on financing and financing options for a home than everyone your age and everyone in their 20s.
So what you do is you find a house you want to buy. Then you save up like 20% of the money it would take to buy the house. You go to the bank. You give them that money. Then they give you a lot more money, and then they get all that money from someone named Freddie or someone named Fannie, and then Biden gives them that money, and then I'm in a house?
No, what you need to do is...
Damn it! God damn it! I thought I had it!
You're close, you're close. You need to save up 20%, and then you use that 20% to buy bats. And then you put the bats in the house. Then you go get the loan. Easy money, baby.
Operation Bats would work. I'm telling you.
We gotta run the sting-style scheme on some of these appraisers. But wait. But not the inspectors, just the appraisers?
Just appraisers.
What if we get the inspector in on the deal with us? What if we give the inspector $10,000 to be like, I found a lot of bats inside this house. It's worthless, unless you love bats. Next thing you know, me and you dress like Dracula, Draculaura. We love bats.
We love bats. We're the bat people.
We're the bat people.
This is the bat house.
No, next thing you know, we're living in the bat cave. All right. Listeners, next week's show will be more normal. You leave us a voicemail at 848-863-5343 or email to theloudestpodcast@gmail.com. We love you. We'll talk to you later. Time to fly away like bats.
Bye. That's all bats is. Bye.